pick it. It's just to fix it. I take the whip from that delivery. Just need some wrenches. A couple minutes, check the engine. What's the symptoms? Is it firing? Check the pistons. How's the tranny? How's it shifting? Is it slipping? Ain't no quitting. I'm on a mission, feeling driven. Ain't no stopping till the tire's spinning. Resuscitate the rod, it's the nursing garage. Resuscitate the rod, it's the nursing garage. Resuscitate the rod, it's the nursing garage. Resuscitate the rod, it's the nursing garage.
What's up, guys? Welcome back to the YouTube video. Sorry for the wind. I'm gonna make this intro really fast. So today, guys, as you guys know, we hurt the motor on the Chevy, Honda Chevy, also known as Special K. Now is her name, official name. So what I had went ahead and decided to do, guys, is go pick up this freaking k24 a4. I know these don't hold that very much power, guys, but I'm not about power. I'm about us making an event. I'm gonna fix this motor in the meantime, but for right now, we're gonna put this in the truck, put it on 8 pounds, fresh injectors, do it right this time. So we're gonna head over to Caleb's now. We're gonna drive on 3 cylinders. It's okay, it's not a big deal. Go put it on his lift, take the motor out, and set that new motor in, and let's just get it going. Got a lot of stuff to do, and we only got 2 days, so let's get it going.
What's up, dude? This is not good. Not good at all. But it's all right. Keep on keeping on.
All righty, guys, just got to Caleb's. Shout out to Caleb for letting us always just use his lift in his area right here. So we're gonna start off just like it went back together like 2 weeks ago. So we're gonna do the hood
clip.
Yeah, front clip. Yeah, there you go. We're taking the whole front clip off like usual. We're trying to figure out if we're gonna do engine and tranny together, and that's it, guys. So literally, you guys have seen me do this about 3 or 4 times now, so should be pretty textbook for us. The other thing that we're trying to figure out is what we're gonna do for oil pan, because I've had problems with this oil pan dripping, so I don't know if I really want to reuse this oil pan, or if I, the one that was in it, I drained it when I got it, and it had all, obviously oil in it. Oh, heads up on this motor, guys, I didn't really talk on it. So this motor has 60K, came out of a running driving car, seen videos on it. So pretty much everything we need just to throw a bunch of boost at it. Just kidding, I'm only gonna throw 6 pounds just because it's already Thursday and we have Cleetus in cars, and we're going to try to get this thing drivable tomorrow for Friday, and then that way we can load up on Saturday. So literally have 2 days to do this. So thank you again to Caleb for just letting us try to jam this thing out real quick, and that's it. So I have an extra fitting that we can put in this one, because that's where it's kind of leaking from on the old pan, so we can run our old fitting in there. And I have another oil pan too, I just got to go grab it. So we can, few things we got to do, guys, just simple drill and tap stuff, but that's it. So we're gonna start tearing apart the front here in a minute. We're gonna let it cool off and just start jamming it out. So see you guys in a minute. Okay, guys, I forgot the time lapse, I'm not gonna lie. So hood's off, intercooler's off, about to take fenders back off because it was just so much easier to do that last time, and we're just trying to wait for it to cool off. It's a bummer, man, but this is why we do this stuff, I guess. Is what we say, or we lie to ourselves. I don't know.
It's a lie we keep telling ourselves.
And Caleb, we're like, oh, it ain't bad. At the same time, we're just like, damn, here we go again. Alrighty, guys, so we got a question because we can't seem to figure it out. There's oil sitting all up here, and it seemed to have came all through over here. So if you guys wouldn't mind in the comments sharing your guys's,
what is this?
I don't know, we gotta Google that. We gotta figure out where oil's coming out of there for some reason. If you guys wouldn't mind helping us out figuring that out. But yeah, guys, making really good progress. You know, we're just taking our time. Caleb's admiring my backyard work, and that's it. Here we go. Alrighty, boys, just pulled off the throttle body. Trying to check to make sure that, or the intake, throttle body, same thing. Trying to make sure we ain't got no bent rods in there.
I don't know, when the...
It's a lot of oil.
One exhaust valve is wide.
You said what?
One exhaust valve is wide open.
You want me to turn the motor and see?
Yeah, I think it's too far open. I think you broke the spring or something.
Retainer? Well, hey, if it's a retainer,
that would be why you have zero compression.
That makes sense why I have zero compression. Do we pull
the valve cover?
Pull the valve cover and turn it? Why not change the motor?
Because the valve is too far. The valve looks like it's further down than an open valve.
The very back valve here.
I'll just see it for the camera.
It's hard to tell. Let me grab my big light.
This, look at that.
You can't. It's just gone. All your hardened surface is missing on most all of them.
So I know this motor ran, guys, when we put it in, and I'm not knocking anyone or anything about the motor, but it had a long life. So I'm pretty sure that's what. That's probably what had happened, is it just had a really long, unfortunate life, and I put some boost to it. I don't think anything I did was my fault, guys. I think, honestly, this ring's retired. We're not going to put any false information out there because we don't know. Rusted and tired. Can't. Yeah, dude.
That means the cylinder had the surface rust on it. Also, when you fired it up, it wiped out the rings. That's why you're dumping oil.
So, kind of sucks for this, guys, because we're probably gonna need a whole new like cam assembly.
Yeah, rockers.
So it's like it was just sitting on for a while with just like
water.
Yeah, because that other motor, we pulled the valve cover on the other motor, guys, and it looks like mint. It looks good in there. So.
Well, they simplistic.
All right, guys, back to the basics. A couple more bolts and just coming right out and keep on keeping on. Remember the one that we got from the junkyard? They're all the same pans, k20, k24. So we're waiting to put this engine in now, and that's it. So I'm gonna look at anything I can nitpick to figure out right now if I gotta clean something, a little bit of oil spillage, and then go from there. But for the most part, should be almost ready to go in. So it's kind of a bummer, but we'll be all right. And we're gonna check those injectors, but looking like the injectors are okay. But on that note, I'm pretty happy that we don't have to re-bleed this or do anything because we just pulled the engine this time. So keeping on. So let me guys know what you think. Clutch looks fine. Looks like clutch. So not too worried about anything else, just that. And then we gotta do the water pump. So we're getting there. All right, guys, I know we went through a fast forwarding period, but Caleb's like, let's throw some paint on it. So we decided to go a little bit of paint. Obviously you can't see from here down, so we're not too worried about it, but 2.0 is going in. We're excited, guys. We're gonna throw this thing in here, we're gonna get the pan all mapped up, and then there we go. And shout out to Caleb, man, this freaking solvent tank did wonders. If you guys remember, this was the one that we got from the junkyard. It looks literally brand new on the inside. We decided to use our old bong fitting off the A3 bits, drilled it out, magnet, and this thing came out sick, guys. I don't know if you guys know these things. Solvent tanks are super freaking convenient. And then he's also got like a heated one. It's like some crazy temperature, and we put some sockets in there. I'll show you the before sockets if we find one. And yeah, so we're gonna go ahead and get this knocked out because unfortunately we have time against our hands. So let's get this thing knocked out. Dude, it looks so good. Thanks, son. All right, we're gonna get this knocked out, guys, and then we're gonna get set in, and then we'll go from there. All righty, guys, it came together pretty fast. Unfortunately, it just got dark, guys, and I'm trying to put out some banger videos for you guys, so that's gonna go ahead and do it for today's video. I hope you guys like the content. I hope you guys like the channel. I hope you guys want to continue to grow with us and just
pray it starts and that we make it to Cleetus and Cars. So I'm gonna try real hard to put out some videos, but I'm just really trying to get this thing done, guys. So I appreciate everybody, and you know, let's hope for the best and not give it the beans. Honestly, it sounds kind of stupid, but I think I'm gonna run the same injectors that I had. I don't believe it was an injector failure at all, and I'll find out as soon as I start this motor, but I firmly believe that it was just a tired engine. But aside from that, guys, let's just go ahead and get these videos cranked out. I'll see you guys next video.